The final step in your custom view creation is adding interactivity. You can listen for user input events including key presses, trackball movement, and most importantly, screen touch events, all by overriding the corresponding event handlers. Android supports tracking of up to 11 individual contact points in what we like to call Jazz Hands mode, which enables you to complete complex multi-finger interaction models. Now, there's really no interaction required for a wind gauge, but you can find out more about handling input events by checking the Motion Event docs or the developer guide describing how to create your own fully interactive custom views, both from the instructor notes below. Now, be careful not to let this newfound power go to your head. By definition, your users will have never encountered your brand spanking new control, so learning how to use it is going to add friction to their use of your app. At the very least, it should behave consistently with the rest of the system, and you should avoid creating your own versions of system controls. If it looks kind of like a button and works kind of like a button, you should probably just go ahead and use a button. But I think this non sequitur has gone on long enough.